All right, good morning. Yesterday was a long day for me, and I made some mistakes at the end, but I hope you'll figure them out on the videos I did. So I'm going to wrap this up this morning, and then I'm going to literally wrap everything up and send it off to you. So there are a few things I forgot to mention. One of them is on the, not so obvious, about the little metronome. There's a little tab in the back. It says pull or something, but you don't pull it out. It's just a stand for letting the metronome stand up. As we went through a lot of cables, and they get really messy really fast. So here's a cable rack, cable tie rack. You just hang the cables, you know, stick that on the wall and hang the cables from it, and you can keep them nice and neat. And the thing I was making the video with is this little tripod-y thing that it's a clamp. You know, you open it up and put the camera, the smartphone there, and then you start the video and move this around. I'm never going to use it, so you can have it, and you can make your own movies with your mom's smartphone if she lets you. Let's see what's left. These devices don't have on-off switches, and you probably don't want to leave them on all the time. Studio people do, because things last a lot longer if you leave them on all the time. I always leave my computer running, and the hard drives, and the speakers are always on, preamps always on, because they last a lot longer. And it does take electricity, but things usually power down into a quiet mode. But anyway, if you want to turn them off, rather than unplug them, you can use these switched outlets that have, they have individual on-off switches for the power outlets. Let's see. This is something a friend gave me. I met her last week and I told her what I was doing. And she said, oh, why don't you send him this? I don't need it. I got it for my kids. They don't use it. So it's 160 different science kits, electronic kits. And a lot of them make little noises and things, which you could use as source material. You can record it or put it into the Korg synthesizers inputs. Let's see. This is something for Olivia. Okay, it is two wireless mics. It's not a professional level device by any means. It's a simple little karaoke machine. These are wireless mics that two people sing into, and it broadcasts to this receiver, and you can, let's see, there's a reverb in it, an echo. So it's kind of like a miniature effect, but it's mostly just designed for microphones and music and things, for karaoke. And there's a little booklet to describe how to use it. I had used it for my TV to use it to talk into, to set things up remotely for the TV set. And I found I didn't really use it very much. So I don't use that anymore. Let's see. Here's a few other things I'm going to give you guys. These are little notebooks that I have a whole lot of these. And they have graph paper in them. So here's two, one for Noah, one for Olivia. And they're nice for taking notes, drawing pictures and things like that, because they're gridded. This is a video of the movie that I made the sound for Noah with, Run Silent, Run Deep. You guys can watch that. That's fun. And here's a movie about the making of synthesizers. I Dream of Wires. It looks pretty much like that, right? Anyway, it's a story of people that make synthesizers. It's really fun to watch. Let's see, what else? There's probably, oh yeah, there's some books and stuff. Here we go, over here. Okay, let's see, here's some cable ties that, these are kind of nice. They're different sizes. They're flexible. You just wrap them around stuff and you can unwrap them real easily. Here's some books. This is music theory, picture chords, all kinds of chords and things, chord patterns. Picked up two books there. Here's the chord patterns for, because I don't play the piano, so I need to cheat sometimes. And then here's the drum patterns book. If you want to mix any rhythms, it's nice to know standard accepted patterns around the world for like the bossa nova beats or whatever. So they'll show how to set up rhythm patterns. And if you want to ever write your own music, here's blank manuscript paper. There's a few of those. And then here's a book I got once on composing music. And you can read that. Okay, I think that about wraps it up. So the next thing I want to talk about is on the computer. So I won't be taking a picture, a movie. I'll be using my recording software to capture the screenshots. And I'll leave the camera running to record the voice so I can synchronize. And then I'll edit it together and show you some things on the computer next.